Hello, welcome to the Tuesday, January 26, 2021 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Rob today is writing about an Nmap NSE script that allows you to look for a DNS over HTTPS endpoints. About a week ago, Guy did report about seeing scans for DNS over HTTPS endpoints. And of course, the reason behind these scans is that people set up their own private DNS over HTTPS servers. And in your corporate environment, you probably want to make sure that if you have any servers like that, that they are authorized. And of course, just like when you're passively looking at DNS over HTTPS traffic, if you're scanning for these servers, well, they respond just like any other HTTPS server. What Rob is doing here is sending an actual DNS over HTTPS request to the most common URLs used by these servers, DNS-query, and then looking for an appropriate response. DNS over HTTPS requests could either be sent in binary or JSON. Common DNS over HTTPS servers do process both. So for simplicity, Rob here is using the JSON variant of the queries. So this should find anybody using standard off-the-shelf software to implement DNS over HTTPS server, but of course, attackers or malicious insiders for that matter could always set up a custom server that does not necessarily follow these conventions. And software security company Sonatype got lucky again, and I guess with that also a number of Node.js developers got lucky by Sonatype identifying three different packages that contained additional malicious code. Sonatype calls this the cursed grabber malware family, and essentially what this malware is doing is it's looking if the victim has Discord installed, and then it is grabbing tokens, authentication tokens from Discord that could be used to impersonate the user. The three packages are Anon, Chat, Lib, Discord, Fix, and interestingly, Sonatype is the name of one of the malicious packages. And they're playing, of course, in particular the first two, on the name of other popular packages in order to sort of essentially go for typos. Discord tokens and any kind of authentication material like usernames and passwords for internal chat systems, similarly Slack and such, are of course extremely valuable because with this particular, in this case, you may be able to impersonate then a company's developer and immediately gain trust with other developers to, for example, gain access to source code. And last week I mentioned the $i30:$bitmap bug that crashes Windows systems. Well, there is now at least an unofficial patch available for it. Windows software company OSR did release a third-party patch. Always a little bit, of course, a difficult question whether you should apply these third-party patches. For the most part, the bug just causes a temporary freeze of the system and the reboot will fix it. But occasionally, users have reported that systems don't come back. And the source code for this particular fix is available on GitHub. And apparently Proton VPN currently is having issues if you're running certain antivirus software. Not clear which antivirus software, but the symptom is as soon as you start Proton VPN, the system will blue screen. Proton VPN has a brief note on its website that they're working on a fix. Of course, if there's indeed a false positive with particular antivirus software, then there is probably not too much that Proton VPN could do. Well, and that's it for today. So thanks for listening and talk to you again tomorrow.